there's a jar of preserves, garlic, salt, pepper, and barbecue sauce.
How much salt, how much garlic, how much pepper would you guess?
3 teaspoons of garlic, 2 teaspoons pepper roughly, and just a dash of salt.
And here's the peaches.
Oh, no, I almost did the wrong thing.
We don't want to see the label. I'm just saying we don't want to see the label. You turn the label away.
Yes,
there you go. There you go. Now, putting in the
whiskey.
We're going to get the peaches drunk. That's what's happening.
That's probably enough.
And
we're going to stir it together and taste it.
And the sauce. Now, as you see how much was used from this jar, from this bottle. Not much. Third of a cup?
Yeah.
Quarter of a cup? Maybe a little more than a third of a cup?
And that's purely up to your taste.
And that's up to your liking?
I'm going to taste this and see if I've got enough. Here, Deb. You want to taste with...
Trial and error.
The whiskey changed it. It actually calmed down the sugar.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, you still, the mosquito's really strong.
Yeah.
That's what you taste in it.
I'm gonna.
It's strong. It's good.
I'm gonna need a little bit more. Sorry, guys. Just a little bit.
Is that invisible liquid pouring in there?
I can't see. Your hands are in my way.
We're really going to get these peaches going here. They're going to be dancing in that pot.
Yeah, I couldn't taste the whiskey at all.
Yeah. It's not real strong.
Yeah.
But...
And it cooks out. And like you said, it mellowed out the sugar. Just be about ready to turn.
Not quite.
Let me get this one off of the top of this because it's not cooking at all in that location. Can't be sitting on top of another piece of chicken and cook. All right. There we go.
That was better.
That's better? Better flavor?
Yeah.
Okay, watch the eyes, everybody.
Was better.
That's
yes.
More whiskey.
Yeah. Yeah. It is.
Mm-hmm.
My hands are a little
sweet. So the barbecue sauce, depending on the residing flavor you want, would depend on the type of barbecue sauce you make and the amount of the whiskey you put in,
mm-hmm.
along with your garlic and onion and
yep.
your
chicken.
Seasonings.
Now,
okay. Peaches. Okay, watch. The peaches are going to dance. Oh, look, they're dancing already. They're standing up and doing the jig.
They'll soak up some of that flavor. They'll soak up that flavor. And then after we get the chicken browned, well...
Boy, they're dancing now. Look at that. Woohoo! Just until it cooks off anyway.
We'll brown the chicken and then... add that to the pot, and then brown some garlic and some onion, sweat it down to add to the pot, and all these flavors cook together, and there you have whiskey peach chicken.
So, stay tuned.
There goes the chicken. Just kind of putting it in there, make sure it's down in the juices.
One down. There you go. 9 to go.
Like I said, it doesn't even have to be cooked through because it's going in the oven.
So it's cooked most of the way through. But if you were to split it down through the middle, I bet it would be just about cooked all the way through.
Where's my lid? My ketchup.
It's over here. Last but not least.
Like I said, when I do it with the thighs, I get the thighs kind of crispy.
Okay.
There's some onions in the pan and some garlic. My husband always says I don't spice things enough, so leave the spice measurements up to you guys, to your taste. But since this is his favorite,
spice to taste.
Wet it down, the onions. Now, they're just going to get poured the whole enchilada into the pot. And now, a little bit warm. Just mix it all in there so it gets all these flavors. Together, and it goes in the oven. But I'm gonna have to taste this one more time.
The peaches have officially stopped dancing.
They're officially going in the oven now.
So it goes from the pot to the pan.
From the pan to the pot, you mean?
Yeah.
And it goes in the oven and cooks until the peaches are nice and soft. The chicken's completely done. And yes, you're going to have a lot of juice left over. My husband loves it on mashed potatoes. So I make a little extra. You can certainly make less and make it thicker. You can also add a little bit of cornstarch or flour to it if you want it. He just likes it this way, so that's how we do it. I wish you could taste this to know how that changed the flavor.
Well, here on Smell-O-Vision, one day you'll be able to smell what we smell.
It smells absolutely delicious.
Yeah, it has such a great flavor. A very, very good flavor.
And now it just goes in the oven.
So if you try it, let us know.
Make sure if you're putting it in the oven, you have an oven-safe pan. This is cast iron, so I don't have to worry about it. And it goes into 350-degree oven. Ooh, and there's hot pans in my oven.
Whoops.
Yeah.
All right, now we got to pull them out of here.
And have a place to put them.
The sink's off. Okay, sweet potato fries. That's what I'm talking about, Willis. Okay, this is peach.
Whiskey peach chicken.
Whiskey peach chicken. Here's the ingredients. Okay.
Pepper, salt, and garlic. A little tablespoon, couple tablespoons of oil.
Now this is, obviously, for those that don't know, this is...
chicken breast.
Boneless chicken breast cut in half.
I usually use thighs, but for expediation purposes tonight, we're going to use chicken breast, and it really doesn't matter.
So you want to
one side of these.
You might want to look at the camera.
Well, I kind of can't look at the camera. And then I'm going to season the other side. We're going to make them a bit, because I'm determined. Then, let them brown. And then in a minute, I'm going to cut up an onion and some garlic after those have browned. And pull them out, put them in my Dutch oven.
What's a Duff? A Dutch oven. Dutch oven is a... iron, ceramic-coated pot.
And then, after I get all of it mixed together, it will go in the oven at 350 for 45 minutes to an hour. So, my friend over here is going to cut me up.
We got the master butcher over here. She's gonna fillet those peaches like nobody's business. Gonna fillet those peaches like a fish.
And slice them thin?
Yeah. Okay. Well, not terribly thin, but thin.
I'm surprised you found fresh peaches this time of year. That's like unbelievable.
Only in America.
Well, in California, I'm like, I'm shocked. And they're not green. They actually look like they're probably pretty ripe.
But because
they look that way.
Mm-hmm. But because they're going
to
be
wash them.
Are the washy washy?
Don't get soft and juicy anyway.
Well, yeah, they're going to have to. They don't have any choice but get juicy.
Just seasoning that up.
Very. She's going to fillet this peach like a fish.
These are not clean free. You can't get them off the seed. Because they're not ripe.
Look at that. Fell right out of there. Peeling it like a fish. See that?
I was going to say, I wish I could have found a few more ripe ones.
It's filleting a peach. This is peach fillet.
Yeah. They make them like cardboard anymore.
I know.
That's because they pick them green. They put them in a freezer and ripen them real fast.
Very true. They're frozen.
Yep. And then, if you bought a
That's the weather outside.
Have you bought a pear lately?
Why?
They're just grainy.
Are they really?
Yeah, it's hard to get good pears unless you get them fresh from the tree.
Mm-hmm.
You get them in Oregon that way.
Get them out of the husk.
Oh, they're tart. These are tart.
Okay.
He's going to fillet this onion like a fish. Look at that. Fish onion fillet. Barbecue going in, yeah.
For the amount of chicken we're cooking, I'm going to use 2 things of barbecue sauce. Now you can make your
2
own.
2 bottles of barbecue. And these bottles are like 18 ounces, would be 36 ounces of barbecue if you're making it yourself.
Now you can make your own barbecue sauce if you want.
Yeah, Rachel races, that's where to do it.
For sure.
You don't have all the sodium.
Yep.
Well, I like making my own barbecue.
This, though, it only has, oh, wow, it has more than I thought.
How much?
330 milligrams of sodium.
Per bottle or per what? Right.
2 serving size, 2 tablespoons.
That's
huge. Yep. Wow. So it pays to make your own just for the simple fact if you can't have all the salt.
2 bottles of barbecue sauce. At least a whole jar of peach preserves. I have another one if it needs more flavoring, but
1 jar and okay, you could put as much as 2?
Yeah, depends on how you want it to taste, and I'll have to taste it after it all gets melded together. Sugar in it.
Yeah. We were just talking about adding some honey into it. We have some wild honey from our last recipe she made with the honey, garlic, butter, chicken. That sauce you can use on anything. I took the sauce then later, and I actually put it on my toast. It was really good on my toast. Or Navajo fry bread. It would be so good on the Navajo dry fry bread. The garlic butter, honey, chili sauce, because you put some chili in it as well. But you can leave out the chili, see, and just stick it on your toast or whatever you're eating. It's really yummy.